Hazrat Khuraym radiyallahu anhu, Khuraym bin Aws radiyallahu anhu says, and this is a report in Al-Bayhaqi, that I came to Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam after the expedition of Tabuk, and I was in his company when his uncle Al-Abbas radiyallahu anhu sought his permission. O Nabi of Allah, I wish to praise you. Allah's Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, my uncle say, Qul, may Allah ta'ala bless you, and may Allah never let your teeth fall. La yafdudillahu faka. This is an expression in Arabic to actually encourage one and applaud one's wonderful statement. So la yafdudillahu faka. It's not in the literal sense. It's a praise and a statement of appreciation. And then he praises Allah's Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in such amazing words. He says, min qabliha tibta fi dhilali wa fi. من قبلها طبت في الظلال وفي مستودع حيث يخصف الورق ثم هبطت البلاد لا بشر أنت ولا نطفة ولا علق بل نطفة تركب السفينة وقد ألجم نسرا وأهله الغرق تنقل من صالب إلى رحم إذا مضى عالب بدا طبق حتى بيتك المهيمن من خندف عليا تحتها النطق وأنت لما ولدت أشرقت الأرض وضاءت بنورك الأفق فنحن من ذلك النور في الضياء وسبل الرشاد نخترق صلى الله عليه وسلم. What words filled with love. Hazrat Abbas رضي الله عنه, so much of love for his nephew sallallahu alayhi wasallam, who is the greatest of Allah's creation. Oh my Nabi, from the beginning, min qabliha, from the past, even before you were born, you were pure. Tibta, you are tayyib, you are pure. Fi dhilal, even that time when Hazrat Adam alayhi salam was in the shade of Jannah, you were pure that time also. Wa fi mustawda', mustawda' can mean in the loins of Adam alayhi salatu wasalam, and in the womb of Hazrat Hawa radiyallahu anha alayhi salam, that time also. حَيْثُ يُخْصَفُ الْوَرَقُ, even the time when they were taking the leaves of the tree for their clothing in Jannah, you were pure. Then you came down into this land of dunya, not in the form of a clot or a body, but you were in the loins of Hazrat Adam alayhi salatu wasalam. And then Hazrat Nuh alayhi salatu wasalam, when he embarked on the ship, at that time when Nasr was drowned by the flood, Nasr is referred to in the Quran, when Nuh alayhi salatu wasalam says, where Allah ta'ala mentions how the mushrikeen would worship the idols, waddan wala suwa'an wala yaghutha wa ya'uqa wa nasra. So Hazrat Abbas radiallahu anhu is saying, when Nasr was drowned, you were with Hazrat Nuh alayhi salatu wasalam, also obviously in the will of Allah ta'ala, in the loins of Hazrat Nuh alayhi salatu wasalam, and how Allah ta'ala took you from stage to stage, and Allah made you from the best of his creation, the loftiest of his creation, and then you were born into this world. وَأَنْتَ لَمَّا وُلِدْتَ أَشْرَقَتِ الْأَرْضُ وَضَاءَتْ بِنُورِكَ الْأُفُقُ. Then you were born, the entire earth was elated through you, and you, and the noor that you spread through the deen of Allah reached the four corners of the world. The horizons were enlightened through you. وَضَاءَتْ بِنُورِكَ الْأُفُقُ. Every horizon, every country, every region. O Nabi of Allah, that noor that you brought, that deen that you brought, that hidayat that you brought, the Quran that you brought. فَنَحْنُ مِنْ ذَٰلِكَ النُّورِ فِي الضِّيَاءِ وَسُبُلِ الرَّشَادِ نَخْتَرِقُ. That same noor you brought is what is guiding us. This is how we are traveling on this earth. اخْتَرَقَ يَخْتَرِقُ. We are traveling everywhere. Wherever we move with that noor and that beautiful deen that you brought, O Nabi of Allah, O the beloved of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Subhanallah, what praises Hazrat Abbas radiyallahu anhu gives our Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. There's another amazing report Allama Suyuti rahimahullah mentions, where Hazrat Abbas radiyallahu anhu says, O Nabi of Allah, from your childhood there were so many signs and symptoms of your speciality. You're being very special, to such an extent that when you were in the cradle also, I saw you indicating to the moon, and it was as though the moon was playing with you. That you were indicating to the moon and the moon was moving about just to entertain you. Subhanallah. Then Allah's Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says to him, إِنِّي كُنْتُ أُحَدِّثُ وَيُحَدِّثُنِي وَيُلْهِينِي عَنِ الْبُكَى. I used to speak to the moon, and the moon used to speak to me, and it used to help me and entertain me that I don't cry. And I would hear the moon making sajda under the arsh of Allah Ta'ala. May Allah Ta'ala give us tawfiq to appreciate our Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and may Allah give us true love for our Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.